why should the church be involved with the vulnerable? Because there's no way to follow Jesus if you're not. There's no way to do it with integrity. When Christ came out with his public, you know, declaration of who he was and what he came to do, he excerpted a section in Isaiah where, you know, in which he opened in the synagogue and said, "Spirit of the Sovereign Lord has anointed me to preach good news to the poor, set free the captives, and you know, essentially to be a burden bearer and a burden lifter." And he said, "Today this scripture's been fulfilled in your hearing by me sort of coming out and giving my inaugural speech, laying out my agenda of what I'm here for and what I'm about." And so the reason to get involved with advocacy is because you cannot follow Jesus if you're not involved with advocacy, because that's where he is. And you're not going to find him in places where he's not. You're going to find him in places where he is. And Jesus is constantly moving toward and giving special attention to the vulnerable and to the weak. And this involves especially women. You just look at the way that Jesus dignified women who were, you know, rabbis prayed, "Thank you, my God, that I'm not a woman." And Jesus is cultivating leadership among women and choosing a woman, a former prostitute, to be the first eyewitness of his resurrection. And looking at a woman who crashes a Pharisee's dinner party, who's a prostitute, and comes in and wipes his feet with her hair and kisses his feet with her lips and pours her perfume. These are all the major tools of a prostitute's trade, and she's using them on Jesus' feet. And the Pharisees are indignant and dismissive, and Jesus says, "Look, you're never going to know how to worship, and you're never going to know how to love until you learn from her." And so Jesus is constantly turning things around. And turning things upside down and saying, "Look, the kingdom of God is upside down to the way that you think, which means you're upside down. Because God's right side up." And so to get on board with God, you've got to learn to think, you know, counterintuitive the way that you've always thought. And counterintuitive is to